There's an exemption on the line.
Okay.
Are you interested?
Yes, always.
Okay. All you have to do is to get three other players to agree to an alliance or coalition.
Okay.
In which you will share information.
Okay.
You have to become an official alliance with an official name.
Okay.
Then you have to survive the next elimination.
Okay.
Because after the next night, you will have to expose the very same alliance for Pluto and reveal the members of it, along with any information. So you have to convince all the other players that you no longer want to be part of this group. If you can pull this performance off, you will receive an exemption.
Do I have to announce intention now?
Hey there again, America. So I made it through the first round.
I've got a notion of bad luck. I thought I was going to be eliminated first.
So last time we saw each other, I was freaking out about the quiz. I ended up using my Joker chip, and I hope I made the right decision. Sorry, Katie, but I was not feeling confident at all. Sad to see her go. We were working together, but... better you than me.
Katie was like the one person coming into this game. I was like, I want to work with Katie. Me and her have very similar vibes. We're both very introverted. I wanted to work with her.
Not surprised that Katie went home, but I was maybe thinking that she could have been like the mole because it was like the very least possible out of the cast.
Coming into the first quiz, I'm convinced that the mole is Ben. But I'm really concerned because everyone's like, oh, you guys split your answers, right? I'm like, no, all my questions were on one person.
I think the questions were interesting. I was spread them out.
And so I put all my stuff towards Ben, and Lance put all of his questions towards John. And so if I went home or if Lance went home, we knew it wasn't that person.
At this point in the game, me and Jessica are on opposite sides of the house. There's pretty much like tribal divisions of here's X camp, here's Y camp. We've known each other before, so we're kind of friendly with one another, but I don't trust her. I don't think she would trust me. I think she knows she probably shouldn't trust me right now. I'm not going to give her valid information. I don't think she's going to give me valid information. I think she might suspect I'm the mole.
Congratulations on surviving the first eviction or execution, agents. Now you should have a taste of how the game is going to work. All right, so this round will have two more missions plus an initial individual mission and another quiz to end the round. Are you ready for your next team mission?
Yes.
Ready? We're all ready. Okay, so earlier there was a poster board with information about 10 famous moles or traitors from throughout history.
Who called it?
If you were paying attention, this challenge should be a cakewalk. Oh. You guys need to divide yourself into a group of four timekeepers, four seekers, and two appraisers.
The appraisers should probably be the people that like know it the most.
Yeah.
I don't know it.
Who wants to be a
seeker?
I'm gonna appraise this water. It is clean for consumption.
It's from Chernobyl, so you probably don't
have to worry. Adam, we're trying to start.
This is a challenge taken from season 5 of The Mole. This challenge is based on the 10 famous moles of history. The four seekers will search this entire outdoor area. We've designated three areas. You can find them by looking for the white lattice on the ground.
It could be a free traffic area.
Filled with index cards. On each index card is written a name or item of index card that Four Seekers have. The Four Seekers' job is to bring as many of the cards to the appraisers as possible. The appraisers will then decide which cards they have pertain to which famous mole. They will have three guesses to get this right. Each correct answer is worth $3. Each time they guess, we will inform them how many items they have correct. And they can lock at any time. Meanwhile, our timekeepers will be filling a bucket that has holes in the bottom with water. They must keep the water in the bucket from becoming completely empty. When it is empty, the game is over. They will be using smocks to refill the bucket. So the game ends when either the bucket is empty or when three guesses have been made. If the bucket is empty before a guess has been locked in, no money will be earned. Do you have any questions?
We had a slip and slide.
Okay, once Carlo pours this water, the game has started.
We're gonna start.
One, two, three, go.
Joe!
No. Yeah.
Nintendo was definitely on there, guys, right?
We have
Skeleton King.
Earmuffs.
No, exactly. I'm not bringing that if I know for a fact it's not right. Toilet seat lid.
Antarctica?
Earmuffs?
Let's hear it.
Well, you have to have 10 on the board. I have to have 10 on the board.
You got plenty of water.
Eight out of 10. Okay, we got 8 out of 10 correct.
Yeah, scooping it from the bottom.
Yep.
That was smart.
We were never told it wasn't the rule.
Yeah.
That was smart. That was a good thing to do.
I paid attention to who like really wanted to be in a role and who didn't really care. Because the mole at some point is gonna like really want to be a specific role so that they can sabotage and be where they want to be. Lance like immediately wanted to go to the Seekers, especially once he realized four people had said, "Oh, I want to be Seeker." Lance stood up and was like, "Oh, I'll go be a Seeker," even though there's only four spots. So I removed myself and said, okay, I'll be a timekeeper. I watched Lance. I see where he's going. He runs back and forth. He picks up some cards. I see at one point he picks up a bunch of cards and puts them in a pile. I can't really see what's going on exactly, but because it's a little far away. Later in the mission, we are missing just one card. Emily finds it under a crate, or under a, I don't know what it was. She found it under something. At that moment, I assumed, based on what people were saying out loud, that some of them had cards hidden under there intentionally. Later, I go and talk to Emily, and I let her know, hey, I think I saw Lance over in that specific area. Emily tells me that was the only area where a card was hidden underneath a little, was hidden underneath something. And I was like, that's very suspicious. That tells me the mole probably put that there.
I've heard from a couple people they thought I was the mole. I might be. Now I think Ryan kind of pinged my radar.
You know what I stole from outside? Fucking card.
I think Emily made a good point about even if we saw the cards and we knew it wasn't one of the answers and we decided not to bring it up, then we would look skeptical. But, I mean, it's, you know, if you chose not to bring one of the cards up, I think it would be, you know, especially if you're not the mole, then, you know, it would be good to kind of, you know, not to bring a card up, even if you knew it was the wrong answer to as a strategy.
Yeah.
You all have your watermelon gums.
Okay, ready, set?
Okay, I got mint, so. Hey, yo, you have move close shot?
Yeah. How about everybody's ready for that one move? How do you guys know that one?
Talking about shooting the darts with their holy cards.
What the hell? Are you
that's
the
what
old
we're standing behind.
Sabotage?
Yeah, right there.
The sabotage.
No. She seems like a nice girl, plucky, spirited. I don't think she knows what the fuck is going on. And that's great, because that's somebody that I think I can weaponize a little bit. She's really nice, and I think she's pretty genuine how she comes off. She wants to be cutthroat, but she doesn't know what this game is.
Welcome to Shoot Your Shot. For you is a board full of envelopes, some of good, some of bad things inside them. Some of them will add money to your group pot, some will subtract money. There's even a few punishments here, as you can see. There's an exemption in plain sight. And what we're going to do is we're going to be using a Nerf gun and shooting at the targets, or whatever your target may be. We're going to be using some little paint so that we can see what you hit. We're going to use different colors for each round because we're going two rounds. All of you are going to shoot once. And when you hit something, it's out of play for that round. So you're not going to hit the same.
Shot my shade.
That counts as your first round. Yeah.
Wait, loosey booty.
The punishments don't last for both rounds, so if you get a hit a punishment or an exemption, it's out for the entire game. Okay. Damn. There are three punishments on the board, and I can let you know what they're about. The one where the two people are frowning, holding hands, if they're going to be bound together until further notice. If anyone's willing to take that, I'll clear that negative 21.
I'll take it.
Okay.
I heard you first. You're going to be bound to someone.
Me?
Yes.
I'll be bound to Ben.
Okay. There's also a punishment with a little notebook on it. If anyone wants to take that, I'll put 15 in the pot, and you will not be able to use your notebook for the quiz. Does anyone want to do that? Just for this one.
Sorry, guys. I can't do that.
I can't remember.
$15 for the pot.
1-5 1-5 1-5
Can you tell us what that other one is first, and then based on that, then I can let you know about the plus 15?
Nah, Bayou King.
He's really thinking about
entertaining it, right?
Gotta raise I think I'm the only one entertaining it.
To do what? Lose your notebook?
Just okay, so no to that.
No.
The other one is with the Joker chips. You cannot use a Joker chip on this quiz.
What you doing
about
that?
Hmm?
What you doing?
I'll do
15.
I would have done a little more, but no one took the other one.
Wait, can I ask a question? Wait, can we not use a Joker chip just on this quiz?
Just this upcoming
quiz. We can still keep it and use it the next time.
Yes,
right.
Oh,
that one,
yeah.
Okay.
No, it's better than
that.
Okay.
I was thinking about it.
15
and 5.
Where are you going?
No more like double or nothing for the notebook thing?
The notebook thing, double or nothing? $30 if you do not use your notebook.
Not.
$45 altogether for the challenge. Feeling generous because this was like.
I don't know, if someone wants to take it, you'd be looking pretty good.
Double or nothing?
It's okay.
No?
They don't seem grateful enough because I would do it.
45?
I won't go for you.
Honestly, if everybody would have said it, I would have done it. But then when I saw people was raising their hand, I'm like, okay.
That's the thing, we don't all want to do it because then there would be no challenge. Like, right. Some people have this day.
Yeah.
Because there are like some, I don't know, certain like side missions. If you're like nice to people, you'll do certain things that reward you with them. So I'm thinking this might be.
I like one of them. I think that gives up so much.
So we just gained $15 more, guys.
Yay.
You have like an accounting page?
We're like over 100 now.
You're ready to have an accounting page?
Yeah.
You want to do my taxes?
You add my
taxes. Do my taxes.
Yeah.
For those of you willing to set out to the next individual challenge and not have the chance to enter spy supply, I would like to offer you $5 for your pot. Is there anyone willing to take my offer? So we have three people.
Yes, John and Fancy.
Willing to add another $15.
Yeah.
Okay, if you three will follow me.
Okay. I get the lunch at four.
Agents, hope you saved room for dessert. Because individual challenge this round is the beloved food challenge. It's called Sweet Tooth. In round one, all of you will eat your hot tamales. The two slowest players will be eliminated.
Wait, are we playing for something?
Individual challenge, sis.
Individual challenge.
Spy supply.
You're playing for immunity.
Gotcha.
Okay.
You gotta put it in layman's terms for him.
Okay.
Survivor.
So in round two, the slowest person to eat their two Twizzlers is out. In round three, we will hand out powdered donuts.
Ooh.
And the one slowest person will be eliminated then. And then for your final. Peace to the resistance. You will, the final three, will have to finish a smoothie of all items eaten.
Ah, okay.
Plus, jar of sweet pickles.
Pickles! I can't do pickles.
So, while you're like chewing, keep your hands on the table.
Okay.
Then once you're done, open your mouth and raise your hand. Okay?
Do this!
Okay. Mark, get set.
Yeah. Hands on the table while you're chewing. Like, you can put them all in your mouth.
Dog!
He's good.
Jesus.
He's all
pickles.
Fuck.
You got this, I don't know.
Pat Gray, out!
My guy, well, you're having a heart.
Sorry, just one.
Three. Okay. Honestly, let me tell you what the mistake was once they
done. Okay, John and Emily.
Oh, you
did.
The mistake was putting them all in your freaking mouth at one time. You fucking gummy bitch.
I did three at a time.
On your mark, get set, go.
Fuck.
Jimmy, grab the trash can just in case someone has to yak.
You guys are all about the same spot, except for Adam's.
You have time to chew one. Chew.
Ryan.
Ryan?
Wait a swallow.
John.
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 Ben.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I hate Twizzlers.
Toss that out.
Oh, I hate Twizzlers. That's why I need to make it to the second round.
Yeah, I like good.
Alright.
How many people are getting out? Just one?
Just one, and then three people will go finally.
I would have killed the fucking pilot, no hurt.
On your mark, get set, go.
Drive biscuits. Drive Popeyes.
Don't chew it, swallow as much as you can.
Drive Popeyes biscuits. Good job, Ryan.
Yeah.
Ryan is getting that fucking.
Good job, Ryan.
Ryan's got a good mandible.
Yeah. The little shake and swallow. Right, moist.
Shake your. If you shake your belly, it actually does help. I've watched this on YouTube. Like. If you,
oh yeah, that's how they do it.
Yeah.
Ryan,
moving on to final three.
Wow.
I'll
pick this
though.
You got it. They're sweet too.
Adam,
you got it.
Adam, good.
Sweet tickles.
Ben.
Good job.
Oh, sorry.
Welcome to our mukbang.
It is more fun to watch during this rest.
Oh my god. I was like, well, it was red, so I was like,
yeah. It wasn't it cinnamon.
It smells like Bed Bath & Beyond when all the candles mix.
Do what?
Nom, nom, nom.
More
people think bone
appetite
is spelled bone
smack your
teeth.
Oh, look, that's a shot. You take that in the club.
On your mark. Do you not want to participate?
Adam.
Okay, you go away then. Go away. I can't watch this.
Get set. Go.
Oh my god.
You saw Gano with the Christmas!
Move the trash can, is it over
Ryan,
here?
Ryan!
Go, Ryan, go!
Yeah!
Mr. Round.
Look at the cup.
Served you good.
Good job, good boy. Good job, Ryan. Love
well, you won the round, at least.
Better get something good out of this shit. Let me just tell you that.
How to bring out fucking pickle juice. Whoever decided that has a straight shot to hell. Let me tell you that. But you know what? I was not going to give up because I wanted some kind of advantage. Ended up winning.
What a sweet victory. Woo-hoo! And now you alone will go into the spy supply and decide whether you'll make a purchase or donate with your win.
Stop hitting the bricks.
Ready?
All right. So we have added a new item to the spy supply, which is the Kiss of Death. It's $35. Remember, you know you can mark another player for elimination with this kiss. Use the fake ID to see how the most recently, you know, executed player answered their quiz. Or, you know, you get two chips.
Two chips. This is a tough decision.
What will he do?
Huh. Well, since I don't have Joker chips, two would be nice. I feel like I know what Katie's answers were, so that's not gonna be useful. This round could be useful for the next round. That'd be the last time it could be used.
Right, they're gonna expire soon too.
Somebody could come through next time and get this and fuck me over. I feel like I'm gonna go with the Kiss of Death.
You're gonna go with the Kiss of Death?
Yep.
Okay.
Ryan Daniel has selected the Kiss of Death, and now we just...
So this marks another player for elimination with the kiss, causing them to start their quiz with one wrong answer, and it's usable twice in separate rounds.
Based on night one,
who did you say?
First impressions, I think Ryan Daniel is the mole.
Bought the Kiss of Death, so I can sabotage somebody's quiz scores. I'd have to use it very strategically, as I want a couple people out of this game. Going into this quiz, I am still very nervous. I'm trying to determine if I want to stick with my same strategy from last round and stick with Ben, the Emily, the Joe and Lance route. That might be too many for splitting my answers between four people, but it could work out. We'll see.
I personally think I got to feel him out. Ben Wood, he is a studier of this type of stuff. I played an org where I was the killer, and he played it, and he is so good at that kind of stuff. So that's someone I'm having my eyes on. But it's devils you know and devils you don't know. So, I mean, I'm definitely looking at the people I don't know a little bit more than the people I know.
Yeah, that's the tough thing. You play Survivor, and your ride or die screws you, but in this game, you know someone too well coming into the game. You can overlook them.
I'm like 90% sure it's Lance right now, 10% sure it could be Ryan, and then my only other two suspects right now are Fancy, maybe Jess. Everyone else I've rolled out.
So let's see, yeah, this was the bet or the Fancy deal you guys took earlier when we did a shoot your shot.
This one is 21.
Wait, hold on, I need the light. That's good.
We need this light out.
How does it feel? How are you guys going to go to the bathroom if you have to go to the bathroom?
One's going to look away.
With a partner.
Why do we have to you just away? Have to hold it.
Yeah.
No.
Why do we have to look away?
Just see each other piss.
I just like,
fair, you know,
they're just genitals. We all have them.
Right?
It's fine.
Yeah. Wait, some of us have them.
unless you're Jess or Ray, who doesn't have a booty hole.
And with that in mind, it's once again time for the quiz. Questions about the identity of the mole. The player that scores the lowest on the quiz is executed from the game.
Is it you?
Not
is it you? You're exempt, so it's not you.
Oh, who's gonna be executed?
Is it you? Are you about to get executed, King Lance? Is it time for you to go? Are you leaving?
Jamie's gonna be the veto.
Are you leaving?
Katie, would you like to say a name? And we'll enter it and see.
Let's look at Adam first.
Ooh. Adam. Wow, that's another green.
Ben. First to go
Jessica.
Both times.
It's gonna be you, Jessica.
How you feeling, Ben?
I'm okay right now.
Lovely green shirt there.
I'm feeling good.
Woo! Oh, I got it. Bethany, your first time seeing your name on the screen.
Yeah, it's horrible. Now I understand how they all felt earlier.
Oh, and they're holding. That is so cute.
Yeah.
I know, I zoomed in.
Alright, let's see.
Yay!
Emily. Ready, Emily?
That's how the computer knows it. Like, sorry.
A-A-Ron.
He's so nervous.
Oh,
Lance, and Ryan. All right, John, how do you feel?
The thing is, I have kind of a formal coalition going, and I don't want to fuck that up, because I think it's a good thing for me. Exemptions are great, but since I didn't take the first quiz, like, having access to information is even more important, so I'm gonna have to pass.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
This game is crazy right now.
Using incredible Victory House technology, and all of the 12 players in this game, I have morphed your faces together two at a time.
I am very conflicted. I don't have one person, but I think the mole is...
It's devolved into this kind of like us versus them thing. I want them to leave.
So I immediately get pissed. Just sit back, cross my legs.
It doesn't matter. What are they gonna do? Vote you out? They can't do shit.
Exterminate it! Cancel her!